For 20 years, Jermaine and I have wanted to visit the world's seventh continent, Antarctica, but it always seemed to be a destination that was unreachable. Then in 2019, the stars aligned and we sat down with Jen Zur at Bethany Travel and Herta Gruten and planned the trip of a lifetime. On February 11th, 2023, our adventure began at dawn with the first of three flights we would need to take to get down to the end of the world, Ushuaia, Argentina. However, before we headed for South America, we had a little partying to do.
Miami. South Beach, bringing the heat. Can y'all feel that? Can y'all feel that? Jig it out. Here I am in the place where I come let go. In Miami, the base and the sunset low. Every day like a Mardi Gras. Everybody party all day, no work, all play, okay? So we sip a little something, leave the rest to spill. Me and Charlie at the bar running up a high bill. Nothing less than ill when we dress to kill. Every time the ladies pass, they be like, can y'all feel me? All ages and races, real sweet faces. Every different nation, Spanish, Haitian, Indian, Jamaican, black, white, Cuban or Asian. I only came for 2 days of playing, but every time I come, I always wind up staying. This the type of town I can spend a few days in. Miami, the city that keeps the roof blazing.
Party in the city where the heat is on, all night on the beach till the break of dawn.
Welcome to Miami, bienvenido a Miami.
Bouncing in the club where the heat is on, all night on the beach till the break of dawn.
I'm going to Miami.
The next evening, after going to bed late and getting up even later, we headed for Miami International Airport for a 9-hour flight to Buenos Aires. It was scheduled to leave at midnight, but just after we arrived at the gate, I got a text saying that the flight would be delayed until the next morning. It was Super Bowl Sunday, so we elected to stay in the terminal for overnight, and after a while, we noticed we had the whole place to ourselves. At 9 a.m., with almost no sleep and stiff backs, we finally boarded the aircraft and continued our way south. By the time we landed, cleared customs, got our luggage, and took a thrilling ride through the darkened streets of downtown Buenos Aires, we arrived at our hotel at midnight, and our thoughts of a long hot shower and 8 hours of sleep turned into a quick shower and a 1 hour nap because we had to be back in the lobby at 3 a.m. to take the bus back to the airport for our 6 a.m. flight to Ushuaia. During the 3 hour flight to Ushuaia, we both managed a couple 15 minute cat naps, but that did nothing to stave off our exhaustion. However, it was cured when we broke out of the clouds during our descent and saw the stunning beauty of this remote part of the world.
course, it was summertime in that part of the world, so the temperature was a balmy 34 degrees, and we had just missed the snow they had earlier that morning. After about 3 hours of sightseeing, shopping, and lunch, it was time to head for the ship. The real adventure was about to begin.